Welcome to the SIDRA Intersection tutorial series. In this video, we'll demonstrate how to use the Route Data Input dialog in SIDRA Intersection. If you haven't already, please subscribe to our channel and don't forget to tap the bell to receive notifications about our new videos. If you have suggestions for content, please leave us a message in the YouTube comment box. Now let's begin. For this tutorial, we will use a network with routes already configured. Under the Route tab, let's select a route to view its layout picture before we proceed. Click Route Data in the Route Input section to open the input dialog for the selected route. The Route Data dialog includes the Route Data and Route Summary and Displays groups. The route name, route ID, and route title are useful for input and output purposes. The route level of service method, desired speed, and lower limit of speed efficiency parameters are very similar to the parameters that appear in the Network Data dialog under the Network tab. When a new route is configured, these three parameters are set to the values specified in the current network to which the route belongs. You can change them to give parameters specific for each route. When a new route is created using the reverse function, these three parameters of the new route will be set to those in the original. Three options are available for the route level of service method. SIDRA Speed Efficiency is the default method for all software setups except the US HCM setups. HCM6 Speed Efficiency is the default method for the US HCM software setups. Desired speed is an important parameter used in the calculation of the route level of service, speed efficiency, travel time index, and congestion coefficient. For desired speed, the default value of the input option is the same as the default value of the approach cruise speed parameter given in the Vehicle Movement Data dialog under the Site tab. The program option for desired speed uses a flow-weighted average of approach cruise speed values of movements on the route. The lower limit of speed efficiency is a parameter used in the calculation of the travel time index. After selecting the desired parameters, the quick input function can be used to set the same parameters for all routes easily. The route summary and displays group lists the route output options that will define the contents of the route summary report, route displays, and lane displays. When the movements option is chosen as the route output option, the results are for one movement per approach. When the approaches option is selected, the results of all movements on each approach on the selected route will be included. When the sites option is selected, the results of all movements on all approaches of each site on the selected route will be included. The OK and Apply buttons in this dialog will be sufficient to set the contents of the route output reports and displays if the network has already been processed. This concludes our tutorial on Route Data Input dialog. Thank you for watching.